problem.
Which God?
You have problem for killing the babies. Babies.
I'm willing to defend
you.
No,
yes or no, on the camera. Do you have a problem with torturing the babies?
I'm willing to debate.
My question to you, do you have a problem? No, I'm not going off. On the camera with you, do you have a problem with slaughtering the babies?
My God.
I'm asking you, God or Chinese God. I'm asking you, do you have a problem
we'll
with
give you
slaughtering
5 minutes.
The babies? Go on.
Go on. You don't seem to have a conversation here.
No, exactly. Exactly. He wants to perform. Carry
maybe
on.
Maybe only timing would work with you.
Can you see? You took.
No, here we go again.
You can answer.
Go on, here we go.
Okay.
So, God of the Bible is a judge. And that would come.
I'll ask you that. You.
Let him speak.
Is it okay to slaughter the babies?
Let him speak.
God of the Bible is a judge.
Okay.
And that might come as a surprise to you because Islamic Allah.
Are you asking that? No. Are you asking that? No. Ask him a question. You, do you have a problem? You. What's your name, by the way? What's your name?
No, Shamsi. Don't worry about that.
Well, we are in Britain. You know what we said? In Britain, we are good to the neighbors. In Britain, you'll be in prison for life just playing with the babies as a pedophile, let alone slaughtering the babies. Yeah. So do you have a problem with slaughtering the babies?
No.
Do you have a problem with slaughtering the babies?
Look. You really
do you have a problem with slaughtering the babies alive?
Yes or no?
Yes or no?
Let him answer. He'll answer how he wants
you,
to answer.
Do you have a problem?
Let him answer.
Headache now.
Let him answer.
Shamsi.
How many times I ask questions?
Okay, here we go.
I'm running away.
Still want to...
He's not going to ask them a question. Yeah. I'm going to walk off.
Walk off then.
I'm going to answer your question quickly and then I want to come to you.
Okay,
before.
Focus us.
Yeah, here we go.
Is the focus today. God
of the... ask you that.
No.
Yes. Do you have a problem?
Stop interrupting him. Let him speak.
Ask you the God of the Bible or
let
the God
him speak.
Of the Quran. You, do you have a problem?
I am quite happy with the God who showed up on the face of the earth.
I'll ask you again. Do you have a problem with slaughtering the babies alive?
Yes.
Muslims, do you have a problem with slaughtering the babies alive?
Yes.
Allahu Akbar.
Have you got
the armies to fight against the Byzantine? He said, do not kill the children, do not kill a woman, and do not kill a man that worshiping his God in the temple. This is the mercy of Islam. And you have the Christian missionaries here, the biggest liar ever exists upon the face of the earth, speaking against our beloved Prophet Muhammad, alayhi salatu wasalam, to show the Christians if their God says, rape babies. They will say, God is a judge. But in Islam, when Prophet Muhammad fought against his enemies, they were a big man, they have a problem with it. They have no problem to slaughter the babies alive. But they have a problem with our Prophet Muhammad, السلام, for defending himself, defending his family. And we have the wife. We have here the wife, Abu Jahl. عندك الله بحمدك شهد لا إله إلا الله.
خي سنسي في مكتب. هي إذا حدث. أصل أوز أوت ستيشن on Friday.
أخي مين brother.
Five people become Muslim الحمد لله.
Right. Just like your chair if you give me that one.
What did he say? Speak English, brother.
Yo, just like when I came here the first time.
I said to give him the to become Muslim. Yeah. That's what we do. That's our mission.
Yo,
alhamdulillah.
No, I am an Israelite. I don't need that Rasta.
You need, brother.
No. Yo, what's your gender?
I put you Israelite, no Rasta.
No, you're my no Muslim around here, bro.
Israelite Rasta, yeah.
Israelite straight, bro.
Yeah.
Israelite straight, huh? Bro.
I love you after.
People to become Muslim and to be
I'm
saved.
I'm Israelite. I will not be nobody.
Peacefully,
else.
Inshallah.
And I will not change for
bro,
no
bro. So my point here is, look. Yeah. In the
he's writing about
I understand
story,
right? About that. My point here still stand that he was not inspired by God.
Okay.
Because so in the beginning...
Let's go to somebody who's inspired
wait.
By God.
No, wait, wait.
Let's go to somebody
no, wait,
who's inspired
wait,
by
wait,
God.
Wait.
John, yeah.
Bro, we have
let's
to...
Let's go to somebody
wait,
who's
bro,
inspired
bro.
By God.
Before we don't have to get angry, man.
You're not angry, man.
You are.
I'm going to use the Bible and show you, bro. You want to see the show?
Step by step. Remember, we should reason it.
Okay.
My point here is that before you go to John, we have to establish if Luke was not inspired by God, so which is based upon his own wording, then how can you trust someone who never met Jesus and you don't even know him? Bro, he's just saying story.
Read.
Yeah, I'll read it. He's just saying story. He's just saying, I know, he said, look,
it's a narrative of Jesus Christ, right?
Yeah, I know, but it's a mix.
It's a story.
Yeah.
It's a story.
The story is narrating.
So Jesus Christ never born.
No, I didn't say that. He's narrating
events. So Jesus Christ didn't crucify and resurrect him.
He was not crucified, no.
Yeah.
Yeah, he was not. How can
you
prove that?
Our people was there. Your people was
not
there.
From the Bible.
Our people was there.
From the Bible proves
Jesus Christ was crucified.
No, from the Bible.
You can't prove
okay.
That,
Hebrew 5:7, read it.
Hebrew 5:7.
They go to Hebrew 5:7.
Yeah,
you go. You know the Bible. You know, where is Hebrew 5:7? You know where is it? He's getting angry.
No, I'm not getting angry.
Calm down, Rasta man.
Hebrew 5:7, right? Come on. Hebrew 5:7.
Yeah.
Hebrew 5:7. You can come with anything you want to come with, man.
Yeah, go to Hebrew 5:7.
Right, come on.
Today you're going to become Muslim.
Okay, 5:7. Okay, read it now. Okay. Who in the days of his flesh, when he had offered prayers and supplications with a strong crying and tears unto him.
Watch.
That, no, I think Mr. Okay. That was able to save him from a death and was heard in that he feared. Okay, so this Jesus, when he was
hit. Carry on, man. Carry on.
The point. Bro. Okay. Though he were not, then he goes, though he were a son, yet learned the obedience by the things which is. He suffered. But before we go to...
No, wait. Read.
Let me finish. Bro,
you can calm down. Read.
Bro. Hebrew. Hebrew 5:7 speaking about when Jesus was on the earth. Let me finish. I'm going to elaborate. Okay. Jesus was on the earth. He was praying to God to save him. And he said he was heard because of his reverence. And we know God hear you, regardless if you are righteous or wicked. But what does it mean he heard? It means God answered and responded to his call. He saved him. Yet, I will agree with you. You can bring me another passages, which is
the same
Jesus.
Let me finish.
Yes, I agree with you. You can bring me another passages, which is going to tell you Jesus crucified. That's our point. As a Muslim, there is contradictions in your Bible.
That's what you said, right?
It's not consistent.
So read with me before you go to 7. What 5 says? Read what 5 says.
Yeah. So also Christ glorified not himself, but to be made and a high priest, but he said unto him, thou art my, this is old English, my
we
son too.
Right? Okay, so we know because the Jesus is the son of God, right? So
I'm not talking about son.
Are you understanding what Shamsi is saying? Are you understanding
what he's saying?
Because he's making a point and you're not understanding.
Yeah, you don't get it.
He just made a whole point and you didn't understand.
Point. You have to deal with the Bible. That's what he's saying.
No, bro.
Hebrew 7, right?
You're not listening. You're not listening, bro.
You're not listening.
So Hebrew 7:5, right?
No, it's a different topic. The son and the crucifixion.
Is that Hebrew 7? Hebrew 7?
No, but you're missing the point.
No, you're missing the point. You read what you want to read, but the thing is there.
No.
It's in the Bible. That's right. Read.
Let me make it clear to you.
Let me make it clear to you. Read.
Let me make it clear to you. Let me make you understand my point. Imagine I said to you, yeah?
Let me finish.
Let me make clear to you. Imagine I said to you. You're gonna hear me. Okay. Brother, I can't prove my point, brother.
I could say you're corrupted, too.
Okay.
Don't do that. Mohammed is corrupted.
John 1:5.
Jesus Christ is corrupted. Mohammed is not corrupted.
Bro, he's getting angry.
He's about
peace.
You're disrespecting, bro.
No, but that's his point.
Don't disrespect. Issa to you, he's got his salvation, right? Issa to me is the Messiah.
No, before. We have to stick to one point.
Otherwise, do not speak. Right, so have respect. Shut up, bro.
Calm down.
When you speak of Issa, Jesus Christ, speak of him with respect and with
honor. Bro, you're just shouting, bro. You have to calm down.
We speak of him, I live more than anyone else.
Where is family? I'm off.
You know, try to reason again, root the people.
Forget it, man.
Anyway, you want to ask questions or something? Anyway, take care, man. I'm gone. You get angry.
No, you're disrespecting, bro.
Assalamu alaikum, brothers and sisters. Hope this video was helpful for you. This may help others too, so please consider sharing. And we will bring more videos in the future, inshallah. So consider subscribing and you won't miss any. Jazakallahu khairan.